This is Dr. Katherine Bankole-Medina, and in today's podcast, we're talking about slavery and the American Revolution. The use of the word slavery was important in the rhetoric of the American Revolution. It was used as a metaphor for the political status of the colonists, and it was also a direct critique of the system of slavery. However, the British observed that it was a hypocrisy for the slaveholders to use the term slavery to describe their own condition, as well as to ignore the fact that slaveholding was becoming very important to the colonies. But there were some obstacles to even talking about the elimination of slavery in the United States at this time. First of all, the slave system was becoming more and more important to the economic system of the colonies. In addition, slavery was perceived as a basis for white freedom. Also, there was the conception of property rights as an essential form of liberty. So, since slaves were property, it could be seen as an abridgment of property rights, and also it meant that if you eliminated slavery in the colonies, then you would be eliminating white freedom in many respects. Now, there were lots of discussion about abolition at this time. There was a growing debate over slavery in America, and the American Revolution made slavery a public debate, made it possible to talk about slavery and the elimination of slavery. It raised that possibility, specifically the complete elimination of slavery as opposed to partial measures. Now, you have black initiatives against slavery during this time as well. You have blacks calling for their freedom and telling the colonists that their freedom is a universal right, and they were using the same or similar language as the colonists to appeal to them. Also, you have Africans filing freedom petitions, and you also have blacks running away to be free, and you have some people passing for free people. There were lots of petitions and pamphlets and assemblies and meetings taking place. So definitely this was an opportunity to address the system of slavery. This was also an opportunity to look at blacks as soldiers in the American Revolution. For example, George Washington refused to use black soldiers, and he had to change his mind after Lord Dunmore offered blacks their freedom in exchange for their military participation. So on the American side, you have at least 5,000 blacks fighting on the side of the colonists, and some of these soldiers were actually substitutes for white male landowners. You also have some racially integrated companies, which was also a very challenging point. And on the British side, you have a good number of blacks running away to fight on the British side. Now, with military service and the idea of military service and the feeling of freedom, you do have some of the first emancipations of slaves taking place. You, first of all, you have a curb on slave importation from Africa. You also have, in the Upper South at least, you have the freeing of blacks, even though most southern colonies were entrenched in slavery and wouldn't consider it. Also, you have northern states very reluctant to offer emancipation, but in all, each state took some measure towards the emancipation thrust. Now, of course, all slaves weren't freed, but there were a good number of blacks who were freed. they, in some aspects of the emancipation thrust, they did not directly free adult slaves. They did pledge very often to free the children of these slaves after they became adults. And then there were other stipulations that supported freedom as well. Now, the last point we want to make is the emergence of free black communities as a result of this. And this is a very good section to consider, because the American Revolution, with all of its contradictions in terms of its impact on slavery, produced a sizable free black population. You have these free blacks adopting names, surnames like Freeman, F-R-E-E-M-A-N, to designate their status as free people and people who have liberty. The free people, the free communities had their own, they developed their own societies. They challenged slavery, so they did not ignore the slaves in the system. They challenged slavery, and we know that at least by 1790, which is the date of the first national census, there were 700,000 slaves. So that even though the American Revolution was is considered the first major public discussion about the possibility of eliminating the system of slavery in the United States, we know that slavery continued. In essence, slavery triumphed and developed even further.